Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to see how to create this stacking transition in Adobe Premiere Pro. Before getting into this topic, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video in between. Please do watch the video completely. Let's get started. I have imported my own footage files, and I will drag one of the footage into the timeline. Trim the footage to around 8 seconds. Color correct, scale and position the footage as per your wish. Now nest the footage and call it as clip 1. Search for transform effect and apply it into the nested layer. Go to the effect controls and at around 2 seconds create a keyframe for position. And at the start of the timeline, drag the footage out of the composition in any side. Ease in the second keyframe. Open up the graph and change the graph as shown. That's looking smooth. Now again nest the nested sequence. I'm calling it as clip 1 nested. Search for echo effect from the effects panel and apply it into the nested layer. Set the echo time to -0.1. Number of echoes to around 4 or 5. I'm setting it to 5. And the main thing is set the echo operator to composite in back. Drag in the second footage into the timeline and place it at the 5 second mark. I'm just color correcting it a little bit. I like the composition, so I'm not scaling it up this footage. Trim the footage till the 10 second mark. Nest the footage and call it as clip 2. Search for transform effect and apply it into the clip 2 nested sequence. At the 7 second mark, create a keyframe for position, and at the start of the nested sequence, that's 5 second mark, position the sequence out of the frame in any direction. Ease in the second keyframe. Change the graph handle as shown. Now again nest the clip 2 nested sequence. I am calling it as clip 2 nested. Search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the clip 1 nested sequence. We are unable to see the drop shadow effect, so drag the echo effect below the drop shadow effect. Set the direction according to the direction in which you have made the footage to come in. I'm setting the direction to -135 degrees. Set the distance to 15, also the softness to 15. That's looking good. We don't want the drop shadow to be seen at the top, so scale it up a little. Set the scale value to 105. Copy the drop shadow and the echo effect from the clip 1 nested sequence and paste it into the clip 2 nested sequence. Also, increase the scale value to 105. Now select the two nested sequences and render them. Since these effects are heavy, we need to render it before previewing it. I should have changed the direction angle in the drop shadow effect. That's why we are not seeing the drop shadow effect in the second clip. We'll change it right now. change the direction according to the direction in which you have made the clip to come in into the frame. It's almost done. Yeah, that's it. Let's preview this. Yeah, that's good. Let's see the output once again. Feel free to experiment the values of the transform properties to get your desired look. If you want this kind of angle to transitions, you need to keyframe the rotation values also. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos. Like, comment and share. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. I will see you in the next video. This is Raudran signing off.